Hi, I've got a haircut. And I entrusted the barber with my coupe. And today is a big day for the trust. Because behind me, we have an Audi A5 Sportback S-Line. And even more things to trust me in. Take off. Michael, you're a mad lad. Thank you very much. Okay, let's do some fancy drone stuff. Let's go. Holy moly. There we have a car. Oh. Okay, let's go. Oh, there I am. Hello. Come at me, bro. Come at me. Hello. But look at this.
Wait a second. Go back.
Oh, yeah. Look at this beauty. Oh, fuck. Do you think this drone stuff is cool? Yes? Nice, really nice. This way. I'm about to shot and go. This is so incredibly cool. Nah, just kidding. Hi. It's obvious I still have to learn loads of stuff about drones. But first impression. Thank you, Michael. This is cool. This is incredibly cool. Woohoo! Boom! Holy shit. Okay. Back to the video now. Welcome to my first Audi. I hope you like the drone shots. At this point, I don't know how they came out because I'm gonna film them after I film this part. But this is an Audi. And with a sculpture like this, drone shots have to be good, right? Anyway, this is the Audi A5 Sportback S-Line. The S standing for stupid, but you get to that later. Next to the Sportback, there are the normal A5, a convertible, the S and RS models, and probably the, well, not the coolest, but the most interesting to me is the G-Tron. Sounds like some stupid movie. We all know the e-tron. It's Audi's new electric vehicle. The G-Tron was a version of this, which ran on neutral gas. You know, the stuff which comes out of the earth in gas form. just, yeah, whatever. And then gave it a stupid name. And the G-tron was born. But that's not this. This is an A5 Sportback S-line. First off, Sportback. What does this mean? Quite simply, Sportback means this. The rear doors. That's literally everything the Sportback name means. So if you would take out the rear doors, you'd have an A5. If you have these rear doors only, not the car, only the doors, you have a Sportback. So in Audi's world, two doors are considered a Sportback. Meaning, if you would enter a house through one door and then leave it through another door, making this two doors, you would have done what Audi considers to be a Sportback. Anyway, this Audi, powered by a mighty 2-liter four-cylinder, producing around and about 190 horsepower, propelling you from 0 to 60 in 6.5 seconds, something around there. But that's not the point of this Audi. It's the driving. Driving this is majestic. It just makes you feel better than everybody else. But we get to this during the driving part of this video, so stay tuned, okay? Anyway, talking about this, the S line. Why does this exist? Audi has their S Sport and RS Rennsport models, which are more powerful, faster versions of the standard A versions. And then they introduce the world to the S line. As I said, the S standing for stupid, because you are diluting your fast brand name, being S and RS, with shit like this. This guy. It's a lease car, so it's not his own. Don't worry. I'm not offending any feelings. But maybe I am. Maybe I want to offend feelings. This guy driving around in a fake sports car. It's practically what this is. And it makes me mad. BMW do this with their M540i. And AMG with their stupid AMG G43. No, not G, but the 43 number. They use the 63 number for like the big guns and the 43 for car brands. I mean, hello? I know you're making a fuck ton of money with this, but come on. Not everything is about the money. With stuff like this making your non-performance cars fake performance cars, you're just fucking over the brand. And this even goes as far, I didn't even bother to research what comes with the S-Line package. I'm guessing a whole lot of fake vents, probably some interior bits and bobs, maybe ones I even like, maybe even these wheels. Point is, I don't care. Make proper performance cars and economy cars or luxury cars, but don't mix everything into just, you're making a big mess. And I love Audi, and it hurts me to see stuff like this, the S line. It's stupid. It's the stupid line. Okay? Now let's move on to the rest of the, I wanted to say interior, but it's actually a review. We're outside, so it's, could the outside be considered the interior of the atmosphere? Doesn't have to do anything with the car, just a thought which popped into my head. Okay, let's start on the outside for once. You know, let's just start on the outside, because I want to. Yeah, let's do that. Hi, we're on the outside, and this makes an amazing park bench. But styling, this is one drop dead gorgeous vehicle. I mean, even with the stupid fake fans and the stupid S-line stuff, you cannot deny that this is one of the most beautiful vehicles driving around. It has to be. It has the proper lines. It has the proportions. I mean, Audi, these guys know how to style a vehicle. I really like the lights. I really like the rear lights, which have this cool whoosh whoosh animation when blinking. The grille is pretty okay still. It's not ginormous, which I like. The wheels and tires, they have some meat. They aren't just full on alloys with like a sliver of rubber. And Audi, making beautiful cars, that's what they do. Okay, this was the front. Oh yeah, one thing about the front, I really like this big and bulky muscular hood. If you're driving, you see this hood, this big thing right in front of you, and you feel like you have tons of power. Not the case in this vehicle, but you feel like you have it. You know, many vehicles which are faster than this, for example the Tesla Model 3, small hood, it just doesn't feel powerful. It's powerful, 0-60 in 4.7 seconds, but this feels powerful. Okay, onto the back. Just look at this glorious styling, this beautiful rear end. I mean, Audi drivers are known for driving fast and driving kind of like assholes. But if this is driving in front of you, I wouldn't mind. Beautiful back end. Beautiful. Small ducktail spoiler, nice lines, and it's so incredibly simple. There aren't any stupid cross lines and stuff and blah. Really, they are so incredibly nice. And they even have real freaking exhaust pipes. Just beautiful. Plain up beauty, this car. And you can see the angles, the lines. It's so freaking sharp. As if it's been folded like paper. I mean, Audi. Shivers down my spine. Maybe because I'm caught in winds, but doesn't matter. Oh, beautiful vehicle. But also down here, yeah, more fake fans, probably some stupid S-line stuff. Fake fans, just why? Don't even bother putting them in. If you get closer than 10 meters, it looks bad. So yeah, but for the rest, oh. Beauty. And lastly, the side. For this, I'll move out of the way and just go and stand behind it. Because, my God, this silhouette. You guys know I love Audis. Audis, I meant station wagons. I also love Audis, but I love station wagons. I would, 9 times out of 10, I prefer the station wagon. Look at this. This freaking silhouette is just, it's so beautifully crafted. This, you're seeing, right? I'm struggling for words. I mean, small little details. Here, let me come across. Like this razor sharp line where the hood meets the front fender panel. Actually, this is one gigantic hood with lines and lines and just miles of hood. And then this continuous razor fucking sharp line, even on the fuel cap. Yeah. Where should I start? Audi knows how to make interiors. It's beautiful. From the gear shifter to practically every single other part. I mean, really, where should I start? Audi makes, I wanted to say knows, but Audi makes beautiful interiors. Audi knows how to make beautiful interiors. And they know how to make a nice layout and comfortable seats. And oh, just, I've missed being in an Audi. I really missed being in a nice, comfortable, luxurious Audi. It's just so incredibly nice. Sitting in here, it just feels like you're the king of the world. Let's start with the steering wheel. I'm guessing this perforated leather stuff is part of the S-Line package. And I like this. This steering wheel, it feels so incredibly well. It feels so nice. It feels so good to have it in your hand. Just unlimited grip on these perforated surfaces. And just grip in general is a theme in here. You have grip on here, on the Audi MMI, multimedia interface. You have these amazing feeling buttons, or well, dials, which are so incredibly satisfying. Also, little volume dial for the passengers. And just everything is so incredibly solid and grippy and amazing. It's truly insane. But let's talk about the multimedia interface. I would prefer this over an older touchscreen because this is incredibly responsive. It's logical. It's laid out well. And you have these amazing dials. So I would take this pretty much any day over most older, and actually over most touchscreens, I think, even over Teslas, because, yeah. But anyway, in here, you have a few options. First, you can go to car, And there you have your Audi Drive Select. Thank you, Audi, for mentioning what this is, because I forgot. And in here, you have four settings, but actually two or three real settings. You can put your auto in comfort. You can put it in auto mode, where it decides itself how it should be. And you can put it in dynamic. And then there's individual, which sounds very fancy, but if you click on it, you have two options, the engine / gearbox and your steering. For them, you have once again three options, comfort, auto and dynamic. So the individual mode is pretty much, if you like the steering in dynamic and the engine and gearbox in standard or comfort, then you choose this. Or if you like it the other way around, then you choose that. But actually, there's no liking one or the other, because I've driven it in both settings. I don't feel a difference. So this feels kind of gimmicky, but whatever. Then there are some sound options where you can position the sound everywhere you want and have a nice stereo system. Stereo is actually pretty nice. Yeah, just standard stuff. You can have a map, you can have navigation, you can have a telephone, radio. But you don't really care about this stuff. The stuff you care about. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? I mean, boop. Camera, why do you interrupt me at the best parts of the review? I was talking about the freaking touch ceiling lights. Best feature in this whole car. Freaking touch ceiling lights. Sadly, the back doesn't have them. Seats, incredibly comfortable. I like the cloth. In general, I like cloth seats more than leather or faux leather, because they are just warmer and nicer and more comfortable. So yeah, you can keep your leather. But one killer feature for longer people like me, I'm 6'2", 6'3", okay, something around this area, 1.9 meters. Adjustable lumbar support. Second best feature in this car. Best feature, second best feature. Okay, let's move to the back. In the back, sadly, the dome lights just have buttons. I want to go back in the front now. I don't want to sit in the peasant button place. But this isn't the worst place to be. You have your own climate controls back here. Well, you can change the amount of air which blows and the temperature, which is pretty much all you need, right? Then you have some storage nets, which is actually nice. The owner of this vehicle stores his, oi, come out, tactical stainless clippers, which is always nice, right? Yeah. And put these back, safe. Actually, there's not much more. Back seats are pretty boring, right? At least in normal people cars. You have some door pins. But the most killer feature in the back, Ta-da! Okay, I was not talking about this. I was talking about... Ta-da! No, actually, also not. Here, this plug. Barely fits. It's really, it's a bit more than one knuckle deep. So, yeah. It's not a deep storage pocket. Actually, the coolest part in these back seats are the stupid, over-engineered German cup holders. I mean, look at this. You have these little grip pads that you push here. And this whole assembly folds open. And then you have your cup holder. If you want a bigger cup, boom, it goes even a little bit bigger. And then your second cup holder, and boom, you have bigger cups. Just, why do all Germans make cup holders so incredibly over-engineered? I mean, this is like a freaking fort under the cup holders. If you had different cup holder divisions measured by strength and durability, these would be at the top, because these you will never be able to break them off. I mean, no drink will kill these cup holders. On to the back, shall we? Hi. We're in the trunk. I opened the trunk with this key. This key, I don't like it. I like the old Audi keys, where you had this little button, and then you would flick open, like the real key, and you just could play with it for hours on end. Most fun toy there is. Well, next to the car, actually, but key thingy, second place. But there are nice things about this key. If you press this button twice, this thing opens, but it doesn't close. Then the left button opens it. The right button closes it. And I'll come closer for this. The ingenious thing I want to show you is that the left button is completely blank. Well, it has no indentation. This one has. So if it's in your pocket, you can just feel without looking. Look, open button, close button. I know this stuff because I can feel with my fingers. Oh, amazing. Anyway, let's talk about the trunk. Ah, so in the trunk. Trunks are pretty boring, you know. You have some nets with some stuff in here. Yeah, some more nets. Some very smart little grocery hooks. Some more nets and some on the floor storage. Oh yeah, and you can drop down the seats. Just ordinary stuff. But if we hop out again, lots of hopping in and out of trunks, right? It has a button. And there you saw the lights once again. Here, little demonstration. Cool, and I know it. Okay, to end this video off, let's start driving. I'm excited. Driving the Audi A5 Sportback S-Line. And this S-Line, does exactly jack shit for the driving. At least it says there are different driving options and driving characteristics, but the funnest thing to do is to give it some gas, shift down a bit, lightning quick, but for a little four cylinder it definitely does not sound bad. It sounds rather great actually. Okay, shift down. Then shift up. Really, driving a Tesla for a long time, I have missed this feeling of being able to shift your own gears, even though it being an S-tronic, automatic, whatever. It's a nice feeling. It's a really nice feeling to just be able to shift your own gears, have some kind of, thank you boss, what was I saying? Have just a little bit more control over the things you're doing. And once again, it sounds nice. Really, the driving of this Audi is probably the thing I like the most about it. Not because it's blazing fast. It's rather slow, actually. Like 6.5-7 seconds 0 to 60. That's by no means fast, but just the sheer stability and confidence you have driving around in an Audi is just, I haven't driven a vehicle which is comparable to Audis. Well, I really like it. I really like the sense of stability and confidence. Things I don't like, there aren't many. For example, blinkerstock. Amazing. Audi knows how to do this stuff. Stuff. It's really, I started with things I don't like, but I don't think there is anything. Really, I don't think there is one major thing I dis... Well, no, I am lying. I was talking about shifting my own gears, right? With the little plastic flappy pedals. Yeah. The S-tronic gearbox. When shifting yourself, it's fine. But we're gonna do a little test. It's in fifth gear right now, just automatically shifting, sixth gear even. And I'm gonna hammer the gas pedal to the floor. And then we'll see how long it takes to take off, okay? Gas in 3, 2, 1, go. And now we go. So, coming from a Tesla where you have instant reaction time from when you push down on this pedal and the car goes, this feels like going back 100 years. The gearbox really is slow, okay? Bump. It's slow. Other than this, I'm really impressed with how this drives. just the comfort, the confidence, the stability, even the blinker sound sounds high end for some reason. Just I'm a sucker for Audis, I can't hide it, and this definitely will not be an objective review, but really driving this, it tracks extremely straight. I'm not touching the steering wheel yet, now I am, and if there were a manual in here, it would be one of the perfect cars, really. Just, yeah, I've said it many times now, but driving pretty much every bigger, newer Audi, also this S5, not an S5, A5 S-Line Sportback. You could sit here for hours and hours on end and not get tired. It's so comfortable. The seat is perfect. It just hugs you a little bit, but it's soft and malleable, and yeah, enough said, right? Enough said. That's it. Audi A5 Sportback S-Line, in whatever order these words go. This was a review. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you learned something about the Sportback Audi A5 S-Line, trying another order, and I hope you liked it. Don't forget to grab yourself a cookie and enjoy your day. Okay? Thank you very much. Goodbye. Yeah. Cheers.